The 2019-2020 academic year was inaugurated with the Climate Emergency and Energy Transition Conference, organized jointly by Rovira I Virgili University and the Tarragona Provincial Council. In this way, the university showed its commitment to the UN's Sustainable Development Goals. For 4 days, national and international experts discussed climate and energy, and a working session was held for political and social stakeholders in the region. The academic year began as normal with a program of 59 undergraduate degree courses, 4 of which were new. A total of 53 master's degree courses were also offered, of which 23 were in collaboration with other universities, 2 were part of the Erasmus Mundus program, and 12 were taught entirely in English. A total of 11,454 students were enrolled on undergraduate courses, an increase of 1% on the previous year, and 1,595 students were enrolled on a master's degree program, an increase of 8%. The start of the academic year saw the launch of the plan for the promotion of the third language, in which 2,388 new students were given English level tests so that their progress could be monitored during the course of their university studies. For its part, the URV Foundation's Lifelong Education Centre provided its own postgraduate degrees and other further education courses. There was a total of 4,604 participants, 10.5% more than the previous year. The 24 doctoral programs had a total of 1,288 students, a 6% increase on the previous year. 146 doctoral theses were defended, 82 of which were given the international mention, and 7 new industrial doctoral programs were set up. The URV's research staff had 1,577 publications indexed in international databases, Scopus and Web of Science, 13% more than the previous year. The university also encouraged the recruitment of talent by creating its own Martina Castells program, designed to set up well-established career paths for researchers. The Martí Franquès pre-doctoral program was expanded by 30 new places, and the 4 million euros provided by the European Union Horizon 2020 co-fund scheme made it possible to offer 50 additional places, which has improved the international projection of the program. Overall, the URV spent a total of 25.8 million euros on research, of which 21.6 million euros came largely from international competitive programs. One of the key factors in achieving these resources was the launch of the International Pre-Award Support Unit for International Research, Development and Innovation Proposals, the USPIR. Since the USPIR was first set up in March 2019, the number of projects funded has risen from 6 to 14, and the funds raised have risen from 1.4 million euros to 8.9 million. The USPIR has also helped 28 local organizations and companies in the area to present 19 proposals, of which 8 were funded with more than 4.8 million euros. In the FEDER call for research infrastructure, the university secured 1.5 million euros to co-fund the purchase of high-performance scientific equipment, such as a field emission transmission electron microscope, an X-ray diffractometer, and a high-resolution mass spectrometer. As far as transfer is concerned, the new URV URIAC Chair for Neuroceuticals was set up. The URV Foundation also employed 172 people and managed 331 projects and grants with 191 companies, 13 more than the year before, for a total of 5 million euros, and 2 spin-off companies. And 3 startup companies were created. The URV's budget for 2019 was 110.7 million euros, a significant part of which was used to pay the salaries of a staff of 3,122. 2,206 teaching and research staff, 513 permanent, and 1,693 temporary, of whom 120 are postdoctoral researchers and 225 are trainee researchers, and 744 administration and services staff. In July 2020, the university received the excellent news that the candidacy of the Aurora Alliance, a network of 9 universities, was one of the 24 proposals out of a total of 62 to be distinguished by the European universities. Only 20 public universities in Spain take part in this initiative, 5 of which are Catalan. For the first time this year, the university was ranked in the top 200 universities in the world by the Times Higher Education Impact Ranking for 2020, which recognizes universities for their social impact on the basis of the 17 United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. The URV was also ranked 3rd in Catalonia and 5th in Spain. Also, according to the Times Higher Education Young University Rankings 2020, the URV was between positions 101 and 150 on the ranking of the best universities under 50 years old in the world, and between 501 and 600 in the prestigious academic ranking of world universities. The university approved its Code of Ethics for the 2019-2020 academic year. The Code of Ethics is an instrument that guides the behavior of all members of the community and at the same time hopes to inspire the people and institutions involved. In July, the Senate approved the document Commitment to Biodiversity on URV campuses, making it the first Catalan university and one of the first in Spain to do so. Last year, we continued to provide courses for the elderly and the extended campus activities. Until the beginning of the coronavirus lockdown in March, 307 lectures had been given, which were attended by 1,742 participants, and 11,500 people had taken part in various extended campus activities. European Research Night, Science Week, and other activities in schools were all part of our initiative to take science into the community. These were attended by more than 18,000 participants. Continuing the strategy of highlighting the value of women in university life, the URV awarded Pilar Benejam, a leading figure in social science teaching and teacher training in both Catalonia and Spain, an honorary doctorate. Also in November 2019, Dr. Encarnacio Ricard Martí, a retired university professor in Roman law, was elected by the Senate to be the university's ombuds officer. It should also be noted that in February 2020, the Governing Council approved the 3rd Equality Plan. In the 2019-2020 academic year, URV students received more than 8,400 scholarships and grants of different types, worth a total of 11.2 million euros. Inclusion and equal opportunities is one of the mainstays of the model the URV is promoting, so no students who meet the requirements will be left without the chance to study because of a lack of resources. With the collaboration of the Board of Trustees, the number of special grants to fund the tuition fees of students in financial difficulties increased from 24 to 51, and a special aid program worth 75,000 euros was approved for students affected by the COVID-19 health emergency. Another of the URV's objectives is the employability of its graduates, and that the employment they find reflects the training they have received. To this end, the employability module was taught in virtually all our degrees to a total of 1,465 students. Tools for Entrepreneurship for Undergraduate Students is a new subject that was first taught in 2019-2020 and was given an excellent rating by 87% of those enrolled. On the 14th of March, the state government declared a state of emergency and the population went into lockdown, a measure that lasted until the 21st of June. In the face of this new situation, the URV had to adapt its activities to the online format in record time. The dedication and commitment of the teachers, and the excellent help provided by the Computer and ICT Service and the Educational Resources Service were key to the success of this sudden change. The adaptability and hard work of the faculty, administrative and service staff and students allowed the academic year to be completed satisfactorily. However, COVID-19 also gave us an opportunity to promote research into the pandemic, for which the URV was awarded 650,000 euros through competitively funded projects in the areas of medicine, chemical engineering, anthropology, geography, education, economics, and psychology. We would like to congratulate and thank our researchers for their ability to respond so quickly to this health emergency. On the 4th of June, the board of the Inter-University Council of Catalonia decreed that the 2020-21 academic year would be an exceptional one while the grip of the pandemic continued. Health situation permitting, the university wants as many students as possible to be able to attend classes in person, but it must also exercise its responsibility towards the university community and the society at large in containing the virus. To make this possible, cameras have been installed in 200 classrooms and 240 tablet computers have been purchased so that drawings, formulae and other elements that lecturers have had to produce by hand can be projected. If necessary, in-person attendance can be reduced and a mixed in-person virtual model adopted fairly efficiently, with some students in class and others online. So although we are a face-to-face university, we are moving into a new academic year with more expertise, and we are better prepared to guarantee quality academic training. Welcome to Rovira I Virgili University.